First, for the spring roll sheet, I am going to take 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour, also known as maida. Then in that, I'm going to add around 2 teaspoons of salt and then mix everything well. After mixing it, I'm going to gradually add 1 cup of cold water. Just gradually add it until you can knead it into a soft dough. Do not add too much water because you want your sheets to get crispy. So after doing that, I'm going to cover it with a saran wrap and keep it aside. And by that time, I'm going to make the filling. So here I've taken 1 tablespoon of sesame oil. With that, 1 tablespoon of chopped ginger. Then I've added a little bit of hing. You can take nearly 1/2 teaspoon. And here I have shredded cabbage and carrots. I've taken nearly 3 cups of each. And then 1 cup of green beans. I have cut them diagonally. Now I'm going to add a teaspoon of Chinese 5 spice powder and a tablespoon of soy sauce. I will be putting the link in the description. So here I added also 1 teaspoon of black pepper powder, which is known as Kali Miri. And then salt as per taste. I used around 2 teaspoons of salt and then 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. And then I added 1 teaspoon of homemade red chili paste. I just soaked some red dry chilies with warm water and then I blended it with little water and added some lemon juice and stored it in the refrigerator. Now adding a teaspoon of lemon juice. Here I have some vital wheat gluten. I used nearly 2 tablespoons of vital wheat gluten. I'll be sharing the link in the description. This helps to give a very nice texture and also keeps the filling together. You may also use cornstarch as a substitute. Now once everything is mixed together after cooking it for a minute, I turned off the stove and then added nearly 1/2 cup of chopped cilantro. Mixed it well and then kept this entire filling aside to cool down. Now by this time, our dough has already set for a long time, like around 1/2 hour it took. So now I'm going to show you how to divide it into equal portions. From this particular dough, I got around 19 pieces. So we'll be making together total 19 spring rolls. This is how I cut it in equal balls. Now I'll be rolling each and every piece. Either you can roll it in between your palms or you can just roll it on the countertop. So here I dusted some flour and then I'm rolling it with this rolling pin in such a way that it is equally pressed from all the sides. Just little bit of rolling and then keeping it aside and doing the same with the other dough. Now what I did was I took 5 dough pieces at a time. So after making these shapes, then I will be brushing some oil on top of it. Just make sure to brush oil evenly on the entire surface and then also sprinkle some flour and then place the other layer and then repeat the same thing. Now when you put the last layer on top, then you have to just dust flour, not put the oil, and then start rolling it, like stretching it, making around 9 inches circular chapatis. By this time, keep the pan on the stove and maintain the heat on low. Now place the chapati dough on the pan for around 10 seconds on each side. You don't have to cook it too much, like don't overcook it. This is how you'll see the bubbles a little bit and that's it, just 10 seconds. And then you have to remove it on a plate and then let it cool down just for 2 minutes under a fan. I will repeat the same thing with the remaining batches. And by the time one batch is cooling, I will be separating the previous batch like that. Make sure you are pulling the sheets when they are a little bit warm. This will help the process. So if you see how thin and transparent the sheet looks, I'll show you another sheet too. The sheets turned out rubbery and stretchy, which is the kind of texture we want of the sheets. And they are so transparent and thin. This will help with the spring rolls to get crispy. Now I'm going to show how to add the filling and close it. So I'm adding nearly 2 tablespoons of filling at the corner. And then I took a bowl of water and I'm just going to damp it at the surfaces and then close it in this manner. And then I'll be tightly closing the entire spring roll by putting a little bit of water and closing the edges well. This is one of the ways how the spring rolls can be wrapped. Now similarly, do the same thing with the other sheet. If you see, I'm doing it a little bit different here. I'm just closing the top and the bottom layers first and then going on the sides. The main thing is closing the spring roll sheets tightly so that no filling gets out while frying. So now I'm going to add a little bit of oil on medium heat. Once it's a little bit hot, then I will be adding some dough piece to see if it is frying well. This will take nearly 1 minute more. So after that 1 minute is done, I added 4 to 5 spring rolls at a time and evenly cooking both the sides. So if you see that particular spring roll, the end opened up, so make sure that you close the edges well with water. Once both the sides turned golden brown, then I removed the spring rolls on a plate. I also put an absorbent paper so that it can absorb whatever excessive oil is there. You can also air fry or bake this particular spring roll. Our frying is completed, so I would like to show you the spring rolls, how crispy they turned out. Even the filling looks so colorful. I have cooked the filling only for around 5 minutes, that is why the vegetables inside it is also crunchy. Let's show you another one, and then after that I will be putting a tulsi leaf and offering it at the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. If you liked watching the video, please do leave your comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Hare Krishna.